السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وحمده على كل شيء قدير اللهم رب هذه الدعوة التامة والصلاة القائمة على سيدنا محمد الوسيلة والفضيلة والدرجة العالية الرفيعة وابعث اللهم المقام المحمود الذي وعدت إنك لا تخلف الميعاد. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعين به ونستهديه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه نثني عليه الخير كله نعبده ولا نشركه ولا نكفره ونترك ونخلع كل من يكفره ويزجره. اللهم إياك نعبد ولك نصلي ونسجد وإليك نسعى ونحفد نرجو رحمتك ونخشى عذابك إن عذابك الجد بالكفار ملحق. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له شهادة شهد بها لنفسه في كتابه فقال إنني أنا الله لا إله إلا أنا فاعبدني وأقم الصلاة لذكري إن الساعة آتية أكاد أخفيها لتجزى كل نفس بما تسعى فلا يصدنك عنها من لا يؤمن بها واتبع هواه فتردى. وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا ومعلمنا وقائدنا وأسوتنا رسول الخير سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه الطيبين الطاهرين ومن اقتفى أثره واتبع هداه واستنى بسنته إلى يوم الدين محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خيرة خلقه وحبيبه بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الله به الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين. فصلاة وسلاما دائمين متلازمتين عليك سيدي يا رسول الله. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. أما بعد، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله العظيم وأحذر نفسي وإياكم من عصيان أمره ومخالفة شريعته مصداقا لقول الحق سبحانه وتعالى فمن يعمل مثقال ذرة خيرا يره ومن يعمل مثقال ذرة شرا يره. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. All praises due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him, we seek His help, we invoke Him, we ask Him, we beseech Him to send the salutation upon the Prophet Muhammad, His companions, and whomsoever follow His footsteps until the end of time. I bear witness and testify that there is no one worthy of worship but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and I bear witness and testify the Prophet Muhammad, he is the final and last messenger. May the peace and the blessings of Allah upon the beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. To proceed, advise myself, the advice that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warning all of us in His glory book, O people of Iman, people of faith, have the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, be mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, be conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and do not die except in the scale of Islam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always to grant to all of us steadfastness in this life and the steadfastness in hereafter, and to make us among the Muslims. Allahumma ameen. O people of Iman, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and say the truth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised those who will say the truth that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will rectify their actions and guide their affairs and their deeds. And whomsoever obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His messenger, indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive their sins and make them among the winners. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us always among the successful ones in this life and hereafter. Allahumma ameen. Choose a topic based on the nasiha that each of us as Muslims should get or deserve the nasiha from his brothers, or he deserve a nasiha based in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or he received the nasiha based on the knowledge of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or the statement of the Salafus Salih, the righteous people, those who came after the companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. According to a beautiful hadith was emphasized by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and it was narrated by majority of the companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is referring to the importance of this hadith. When you have too many different sahabi, too many different companions of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon them, he said, this is through Abu Huraira, through Abdullah ibn Jabir, Aisha, Anas ibn Malik, and many different companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They said the same hadith in Sahih Bukhari and Sahih Muslim. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam emphasized a short statement, and he says, "Ad-dinu an-nasiha." That's it. The religion or the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is about nasiha. Nasiha, giving advice for the salah, giving advice for the siyam. تَأْمُرُ نَاسِ بِمَعْرُوفٍ وَتَنْهَاهُمُ عَنْ مُنْكَرٍ. You're asking people to join good and forbidding people from doing evil. This is an advice that you would like to share, and you would like to see the fruit of it, the result of your advice. The Sahaba was wondering, and they asked the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قُلْنَا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ لِمَنْ, to whom, whosoever deserved this nasiha. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam counted, لِلَّهِ وَلِرَسُولِهِ وَلِكِتَابِهِ وَلِآئِمَّتِهِمْ وَلِعَامَّتِهِمْ. The advice for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to let people know who is Allah, to let people know why Allah deserve to be worshipped, to let people know the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to let people know the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to let people know the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to let people know the characteristics of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is the most merciful, and at the same time, He is a severe in His punishment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punished. Emphasize the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and let people know who is Allah. So this is the advice for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or the advice لله. ولرسوله, Let people know who is your prophet. Who is Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as a mercy for all mankind. How are we going to emphasize this? With the knowledge, with the ilm, with the Qur'an, knowing what the Qur'an told us about the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Qur'an, knowing the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from the seerah, from his legacy. This is how to advise people about the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَلِكِتَابِهِ And you're giving advice based on the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why do we have Qur'an? What's the Qur'an about? What is the Qur'an? What's the definition of Qur'an? We are Muslims. Give me a definition of Qur'an. What do you know about Qur'an? Who deserves to read Qur'an? Who deserves to memorize Qur'an? Who deserves to understand Qur'an? Only us? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not speak only for Muslims in the Qur'an. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks to all mankind in the Qur'an. So you're giving advice for people according to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلِأَئِمَّتِهِمْ And the a'immah is two type of people. عُلَمَاؤُهُمْ وَسَلَاطِينُهُمْ The scholars and the ruler al-muqsitina minhum to support the khalifa and the ruler and the president, the king, if they are good, to help him and support him to spread the good among the other, among the community, among their communities. وعلمائهم, you give an advice to an alim or to the sheikh, to the imam. There is nothing wrong with that. عامتهم, you and I. Let them know about everything. Either they know it or are ignorant about or would like to benefit themselves or to remind them. You and I. خاصتهم وعمتهم. The honored one among themselves or the general advice to the Muslims. نصيحة. This is what came in the Sahih al-Bukhari and Sahih Muslim from the hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What is the definition of nasiha now? A message that you have, and that person is called nasih, and it is the job, and you should know it is an honor responsibility, an honor characteristics. You carrying the mission of the prophets and the messengers of Allah, on the tongue of Nuh alayhi salam, on the tongue of Shu'aib alayhi salam, on the tongue of Hud alayhi salam, on the tongue of Salih alayhi salam, majority of the prophets and messengers, they were mentioned in the Quran, came to their prophet, came to their people with a nasiha. وَنَصَحْتُ لَكُمْ I'm advising you. إِنِّي لَكُمْ نَاصِحٌ أَمِينٌ I wish the good for you and I'm a trust in you with my advice. The advice that they came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The advice that they carry for their people. So nasiha, it's a message that you carry and you wish and the hope, the goodness for the person that you would like to share the nasiha with. It's nasiha, it's all about khayr. Nasiha is what you're hoping to see in this person. You're sharing the goodness, you're sharing the khayr of this nasiha to this particular person. What brought my intention when I came to this country, there is a specific person in the university, in the college, in the schools, school advisor. This advisor, he will guide you to what is going to benefit you. Whatever you are looking for and seeking the benefits in order for you to get succeed to your goal or to reach your goal, you have to sit with an advisor. Without this advisor, you may be misled or not find what you're looking for. You need some help. And that advisor, he will give you the most good for you in this college or in this university or in this school. So the advisor, or the nasih, what we call, he comes with a message that he would like to share this message with other people in order to benefit them. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam emphasized the importance of nasiha, and he says, Abdullah ibn Jubayr, he says, bay'atu Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I take a promise front of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on three things: iqamat as-salati wa ita'i az-zakati wa i'ta'i an-nasihati li kulli muslim. Jubayr ibn Abdullah, he says, I take a promise front of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I promised him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give me the responsibility or the charge of Muslims or become a leader or taking care of a community, I will establish prayer, give the charity, and the nasiha for every and each one deserve the nasiha. And this is the importance of nasiha. Mubayaati Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In a very beautiful hadith that showing us the importance of nasiha, the importance of the advice, it is one of the rights of the Muslims for each others or upon each others. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu qal, qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, lil muslimi sittu huquq. For each of every Muslim there is six rights upon each others. قال إذا لقيته فسلم عليه وإذا استنصحك فأنصح وإذا مرض فعد وإذا عطس فشمت. To the end of the hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what I would like to highlight here: when someone seeking your advice, seeking your opinion upon anything based on the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, based on the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, don't be hesitant to share your opinion. If you don't have any opinion, tell him or guide him to the person who can give him the right advice. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to always make us among those who listen to the advice and to follow the best of what they listen to. Allahumma ameen. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the book, in his book, in his holy word, كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ تَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَتَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ. We are all familiar with the ayah. So this is referring for all of the goodness, all of the khair. Because we need the nasiha for each other. تَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ. You ordering or you joining people to do good and forbidding others from doing bad. To whom that nasiha should go? To these people that we emphasize, to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now we're coming to the second part of the khutbah. How I'm going to give this advice? What's the characteristic of the person who given the advice? Or what's the characteristic of the person, or what's the characteristic of the message that I'm going to give, or that I'm going to share with this person? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَبِمَا رَحْمَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ لِنْتَ لَهُمْ وَلَوْ كُنْتَ فَضًّا غَلِيظَ الْقَلْبِ لَنْفَضُّوا مِنْ حَوْلِكَ. What do we understand from this ayah? Lenient, being easy and gentle in your da'wah, in your advice. Because being harsh of giving advice, it will drive people away from listening to your advice. And this is the etiquette of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam throughout of his life. How he used to give da'wah with his lenient. with his gentleness, with his softness, with his wisdom. A young man came to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he called, Ya Rasulallah, ima ma'na al-hadith, hadith jameel, beautiful story from the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya Rasulallah, give me the permission, allow me to fornicate or to do fornication. You know the story what happened, right? Sahaba get so mad. Anna laka dhalik. How come you ask the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for something that is really evil? It's a major sin. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Qarribu. Let him come close. Bring him. Did the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, like the Sahaba said? No. Speaking to the person in his mindset. He knowing that person, where is he's coming from. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam start asking this person or this young man, أَتَرْضَاهُ لِأُمِّكَ? Are you pleased or you satisfied with doing this with your mother? He said, لَا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. That's not gonna happen. No, O Messenger of Allah. أَتَرْضَاهُ لِأُخْتِكَ? Are you be happy that to happen to your sister? No, Rasulullah. That's not gonna happen. أَتَرْضَاهُ? And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam start bringing, counting all the family's members in his family. قال لا يا رسول الله فوضع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أصبعه على صدري. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم placed his finger on his chest and he made a beautiful dua to that person. اللهم حصنه اللهم فرج عن اللهم اغفر له. Oh Allah, protect him from these desires. Oh Allah, forgive him. Oh Allah, guide him. And he, that person of that story, he says, كَانَ أَبْغَضُ شَيْءٌ لِي الزِّنَا. I start hating anything about fornication. So what the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he spoke to the person and he knows what is he coming from. And he received well the message. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فإنه يا توب المستغفرين. الحمد لله وكفى وصلاة وسلاما على عباده الذين اصطفى محمد النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه ومن اقتفى. الشاهد, the main point in my khutbah, when we give advice to each other, we shall care about one another and we hope in the good for each other. The advice for this person, because I saw something that I would like to see better than it. And I have to be sincere with my advice. I carry the sincerity for my advice to this person. All of us have weakness. All of us has weaknesses. But the person, the one who work on his weaknesses and beautify these weaknesses for better way. Imam Shafi'i, and when you give advice, beautifully said, تعمدني بنصحك في انفرادي. When you have the intention to give me advice, give me this advice when I am alone. وجنبني النصيحة في الجماعة. And avoid giving me the advice in a congregation or in public. فإن النصح بين الناس نوع. Because advising among people, it is type that I don't like. من التوبيخ لا أرض استماع. It is harsh. And I don't like to hear this kind of advice if it is harsh or if it is rough. Why? Because it's in public. Because it's in open. You give the advice to everyone in the musalla. Brother, you have a long hair. Sister, you're not wearing the hijab right way. Brother, you came not making wudu. Brother, your smell is too strong. Brother, how we are going to listen to this kind of advice if it's not in the right way? And this is what the Imam Shafi'i would like to emphasize, the nasiha. How we are going to give the nasiha? to offend people or to make people listen to you and accept your advice. فَإِنْ خَالَفْتَنِي وَعَصَيْتَ قَوْلِي فَلَا تَغْضَبْ إِذْ لَمْ تُعْطِي طَاعَ. If you're not listening good to me, don't expect that I'm going to listen or obey your advice. Why? Because it's against all of the rules of giving advice. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, lastly, I will conclude the khutbah with the statement of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, one of the great companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, إِنَّ لِلْقَلْبِ شَهْوَةً وَإِقْبَالًا وَنَفْرَةً وَإِدْبَارًا. Choose the right time and the right place to give the advice. Why? He says the heart sometimes is weak. I don't want to listen. Would like not listen to anything. And he goes away from you. You can't control it. It is not the right time to give me an advice. It's not the right place to give me an advice. إِنَّ لِلْقَلْبِ شَهْوَةً وَإِقْبَالًا. When the heart desire to listen to your advice, choose the right time. There, take this advantage of this time and this place and give the advice. And stay away from the nafra and dubur of the hearts. When the hearts become harsh and have no desire to listen to any advice, don't give this person the advice. Choose the privacy. Respect the person in front of you to give him the advice. In the musalla, in general, this is Ammatul Muslimin. This is our religion. Sadly, we live in a time in a confusion. A lot of people not practicing Islam in the way that should be practiced. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us all to the straight path, to the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma ameen. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdik. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات. ربنا إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات حينا وميتنا يا رب إنك سميع الدعاء. اللهم اشفنا واشف مرضانا وعافنا وعاف مبتلانا وارحمنا وارحم موتانا. ربنا إنك عالم بنا خبير بما نصنع وبما نفعل. اللهم هيئ لنا من أمرنا رشدا واجعلنا من عبادك الصالحين السعدا. اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى. اللهم يسر علينا ما يسرته لأهل طاعتك وأهل محبتك. اللهم صب علينا الخير صبا. اللهم اقنا شر عبادك يوم تبعث عبادك. اللهم نقنا من الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن إنك سميع الدعاء. Lastly, inshallah ta'ala, the announcement of today, please join us tonight after Isha to meet our candidates for the Cambian Shura election. The event will be held in a person and live stream virally masjid.org. So please, if you're not able to come, share your feedback, share your advice for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, meet the candidates and know who is going to represent you in this masjid. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring all the khair for all Muslims. Allahumma ameen. Wa aqim as-salata inna as-salata tanha 'anil fahsha'i wal munkar wa dhikrullahi akbar wallahu ya'lamu ma tasna'un.
Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa Allah. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. استووا تراصوا اعتدلوا straight in line please for the gaps. حازوا بين مناكي والأقدام سد الخلل. الله أكبر.
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين ومن أحسن قولا ممن دعا إلى الله وعمل صالحا وقال إنني من المسلمين ولا تستوي الحسنة ولا السيئة ادفع بالتي هي أحسن فإذا الذي بينك وبينه عداوة كأنه ولي حميم وما يلقاها إلا الذين صبروا وما يلقاها إلا ذو حظ عظيم وإما ينزغنك من الشيطان نزغ فاستعذ بالله إنه هو السميع العليم الله سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما الله سمع الله لمن حمده الله الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام